In this video, we will go over the travel items that I use on all my travels that you can gift to the travel lover in your life, whether it's for Christmas, their birthday, or whatever. I will show you how I use these items with footage from my actual travel videos in Iceland, Ireland, San Francisco, Thailand, Jamaica, Hawaii, and Turkey. And those are just some of the places I've already been. These gift ideas are all different costs, so stay tuned for all and let's get started with the most useful first. When traveling to different countries, people usually have all sorts of different devices and appliances that they want to use while in those countries. Now, you will want to use those electronic devices no matter where you stay on any of your travels. I mean, if you want to see my hotel and Airbnb rooms during my travels, I stay in some pretty unique places. Tree houses, cave hotels, huts, other places. A way to make sure all different plugs and devices I use work in whatever country or place or hotel I stay in is to have a universal travel adapter. I have a few of these because I have a lot of devices, but this is the one I prefer, and I will link to the newest model of it in the description and everything else I'm going to talk about in this video. I will link to below. This adapter accounts for all the different outlet types in different countries and lets you plug in whatever device you want. And that includes multiple USB and one USB-C port for charging multiple phones and devices. I highly recommend every traveler have at least multiple of these. The next items I would get a traveler are any type of mount for GoPros, cell phones, and other devices to film their travel excursions, and you don't need a GoPro for them. I have a few examples. First, you can buy cases basically that turn your cell phone into a GoPro by adding a GoPro mount connection to the phone case. So then you just mount your phone to whatever GoPro mountings that you have or that you're going to buy and use the phone cameras exactly like a GoPro. Second is a gift for travelers that don't have any GoPro mountings yet. So here on Amazon is an amazing universal pack of mountings for GoPro connections. This one comes with a head, chest, car window suction clamp, and other popular mountings for people that like to capture their travels. These make great gifts and can be used with that cell phone case connection that we just talked about as well. Or if they have a GoPro, it can obviously be used with the GoPros. Third, if your traveler already has mountings for all the normal things that I just went over, then some mountings I have noticed people don't often have are snorkel and goggle mounts for underwater footage. These are amazing to connect your GoPro and just get all your underwater travel excursions. They are amazing. Lastly, if they have a bigger camera to capture all their footage on their travelers, there are underwater camera bags. I use this underwater camera bag all the time, not just for going in water and filming, but also if it starts raining or in wet places like under waterfalls. So it just doesn't have to be underwater. You can protect your camera in almost any situation if you have one of these waterproof camera bags. Everything I discuss, like these bags and all those mounts, I link to below this video in the description. The next device I highly recommend is a traveling Wi-Fi hotspot router device. I used to rent these hotspots wherever I went on my travels. Now I just bought one. I will link to the website below where you can get this specific device. These devices can get you internet and get you global coverage for your almost anywhere you go. They can get you 4G connection and can connect up to 5 devices at once. There are no contracts for these Wi-Fi hotspots, and any day or days that you want internet connection, you just go pay a few dollars for the day that you are going to be connected, and wherever you're at, you get internet for those days. For us, these have been awesome as we like to watch TV shows and movies on our trips at night and also in the car. This way, we don't have to rely on our hotel's Wi-Fi because, let's be honest, most of the time internet is really bad in hotels. However, My main purpose for having one of these is that I drive a lot in all these countries, and I use the Wi-Fi from this device to look up places and directions for my GPS on my phone. One time driving in Jamaica, I got lost on this 6-hour drive up in some random mountain due to bad directions, and it was nighttime and super sketchy, and no one was around to help. And luckily, I had this internet and I was able to look up alternative directions and got us out of that situation. But yes, super sketchy, and this was a lifesaver. Now, some people rely on roaming charges and international data plans for their travel, but I have found that this is much more reliable source for internet. The next thing to get a traveler is a backpack. Now, you need to choose a backpack depending on what kind of travel they do. I actually take 2 backpacks on all of my trips. One, I use to carry all my filming devices, which is quite extensive for me. The other backpack I use is for all my daily needs. In my daily needs backpack, I put stuff for the baby, because I take my baby on all my travels, and anything else I need for that specific day. My camera backpack is customizable, so you can put whatever you want in it and change the compartments to make it work and protect and pad everything into place. For me, I put my big camera in it, my drone, GoPro, all their accessories, batteries, lenses, laptop, my external hard drives, all my wires, and my passports, and probably some other things I can't remember right now. And yes, all of this fits into the backpack that I purchased. Oh, and my daily backpack also has a solar panel for charging devices. That's especially handy for people that are gonna be out in the wilderness quite a bit. So my advice is get them a backpack with one of these solar panels on it, or if they're a big backpacker and they need a really huge backpack, just get them a solar charger for their devices. And that's another great gift idea. But these backpacks are awesome no matter which one you get. Another gift I recommend is the right cameras for travelers. Almost every traveler I know loves capturing their travels. I want to go over both a regular camera and then a drone camera that you can get your traveler. This is obviously the most expensive gift for travelers that I will go over in this video. But you need to understand the traveler to understand the camera they need if you're gonna buy one for them. For most travelers, the style of filming and capturing footage that you do is called run and gun filming, or run and gun photography. This basically means normally you have no time for setup for whatever you're trying to capture. And if you take too long setting up, you miss the moment that you're trying to capture for footage. And I will tell you the camera that works best for me, but if that is too expensive for you, at least you know the problems, so you can find a camera that will settle those problems for your traveler. Now, since you don't often have time to set up a tripod, what you need is a camera that steadies your shot naturally. Plus, a lot of travel excursions they will be on will be really bumpy. Well, some cameras can actually steady the footage for you with something called internal stabilization. So you will want to get a camera that will smooth out your footage with that internal stabilization. Then, if they like a lot of video footage on their travels, to further smooth out your footage, what you want is a high frame rate camera, or high FPS. So if you have a camera with high frame rates, you can slow down the footage, and that further smooths out your footage. Plus, slow motion is just awesome when you're accentuating your travel location. I like to have a camera that can film at least 60 FPS, or frames per second, but ideally 120 frames per second. The next thing that you need to have is the camera that can do great low light performance, because you can't add light wherever you want to as a run and gun shooter. You don't have time to set up lights. And a lot of your activities will likely be at night. For my travels, I was able to capture the northern lights in Iceland and the glow of the bioluminescence in Jamaica, and so on. And this is because of my camera's low light ability. And the last thing that you need is your camera to not look too obvious. Why? When I was in Turkey, the mosques didn't want people with big professional cameras to enter, or they have to pay an extra fee. One of the ways most places determine if you're a professional photographer or videographer is by how big your camera looks. And so therefore, you want your camera to look small and unprofessional, actually. actually. Oh, actually one more thing about your camera. You want your camera to maintain autofocus on whatever you're shooting. Autofocus helps lock the focus on whatever you're shooting while blurring the background to make it look buttery smooth and professional. So I will recommend my favorite camera below. The only time I don't recommend this camera is if you're a professional photographer as well, in which case I recommend another camera, and I will explain all that below and so you know which is which. Lastly, let's move on to the drone. If you are looking for a drone camera best for travel, I have five main things I look for. One, how quiet is the drone? The biggest problem most people have with drones is noise. They make so much noise sometimes. And if the noise captures people's attention, it will likely cause some people to ask you to stop droning or cause other issues. If they can't hear the drone, they most likely won't care that you're droning. And they won't even know that you're droning as well. Now, drones are all loud, but the one I link to isn't too bad. And the second thing you look for is how fast of a setup can your drone do? I can get my drone up out of my backpack and in the air in less than 1 minute. And most take about 3 to 5 minutes. The third thing, small for carrying. The drone needs to fold up very, very nicely and is best if the propellers can stay attached also for that fast setup. Four. Its ability to follow and track the subject. This is one of the coolest things about drones. You can get quality footage while filming yourself because they are able to follow and track you. So this works best for that solo traveler that wants to get really good footage of themselves on their trips. They just have their drone follow them and track them and gets amazing, amazing quality footage. Five, image quality. This is pretty obvious, but some can get pretty bad images. So you wanna make sure your drone gets good image quality. And once again, I link to the one I used below. Well, this is my best gift ideas for traveler lovers in your life. For me, these are all essential items in my travel that I take wherever I go. Watch some of my other travel videos or my videos on health and home automation. I always strive to blow your mind and never waste your time. So subscribe, like, and watch another video now.